This followed a concern raised by Sarah Opendi, the Toro District Woman MP, who wondered why the university officials have made it their business to dedicate what female students should do with their bodies, and asked the Minister of Education and Sports to reign over the errant university officials.
Attention by a concerned student at Kampala International University. This is an internal memo written to female nurses and midwives, and requiring them to go for pregnancy tests and pay 5,000 shillings to accounts before they sit for the national examinations. And right honorable speaker, this is discrimination of the highest order if this is true. And right honorable speaker, I want to request the Minister of Education, these are adults, the Minister of Education, to follow up this matter.
I can make that allegation just to destroy the name of KIU. Now, before we accept that document, can we ask the Minister of Education to get the document and verify if that document is really from KIU?
It is regrettable in a sense that if our female students are discriminated to that level, then there is a problem.
The concern by lawmakers is in relation to a memo that was issued on 8th November 2022, where the Dean of Students of School of Nursing and Midwifery ordered all female midwives and nurses to undertake a compulsory pregnancy test and threatened to bar students found pregnant from sitting for their examinations.
What we should do is to ascertain the authenticity as you guided, and number three, to have a written response over this to Parliament of Uganda, so that it goes on record and no another institution will do that again.
Maybe that institution wants to make an arrangement for pregnant mothers to sit in a particular place or something. But when we sit here...
Following the revelation before Parliament, the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, questioned the authenticity of the memo, arguing that the said memo could have been faked in order to soil the image of the university, and tasked the Minister of Education and Sports to establish an authenticity of the document before a decision is taken by Parliament.
Honourable members, if it is true, that is unfortunate. Can I ask the Minister to go and make a confirmation whether that document is really true?
As Muslims, we don't encourage children to get pregnant before marriage. So nobody should ever, whether you're putting on a Muslim-like dress, to say that the hajjat is unhappy because the school is checking pregnancy. In our faith, it is haram. You simply cannot.
Peter Ogwang, the State Minister for Sports, confirmed the authenticity of the memo and said that as soon as the Minister of Education got wind of the memo, the university was called to order.
But as a ministry, the moment we got that information, we were able to communicate to the university, and as I speak now, that decision has been reversed by the ministry, and such actions are not going to continue. And this goes to all public universities in the country.
Meanwhile, the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, has called on government to have a formal conversation to end the spate of kidnaps and enforced disappearances. This was after the Nakaseke Central Legislator, Allen Mayanja Sebunya, raised a matter of national importance over the recent arbitrary arrests of relatives of the former minister, Abdul Naduli.
We have a judicial system that is claimed to be very much independent. We also have the security system that, of course, they swear before entering that, of course, they will be the protector and the guarantors of peace of our lives and property. But of course, it is the contrary.
Things have been in this house for too long. Can we really, for the last time, have a session on these issues? And let's have a session on these issues, and we have all the names. We can have a private session first before we come to the House, and we report to the House on actions that we've taken.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.